I've heard that it was such a life-changing experience for both us and the kids. So the first time that I actually got to experience that and actually hold a kid and see them smiling because we were at the field was probably, you know, that was definitely an experience that I'll take away from this.
The field acts as just that focal point, that center of the township now that it never had before.
The field has really changed the lives of many of the people in the township, and you can really see that.
You know, I'd never seen a rhino before. You know, I'd never touched an elephant. You know, a lot of firsts for me, which I think is what this trip is all about, a lot of firsts.
The bungee jumping was above and beyond my wildest dreams of anything I'd ever do. Ziplining was amazing.
So we've had a taste of kind of the social, the cultural, and historical aspects of South Africa.
You know, it really reflects what the entire D3 experience is and what F&M provides my son and the rest of the students on this team, players on this team. You know, it's everything from, you know, being able to see, to be able to give back, to be able to see what others are experiencing across the world.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight if you need help, if you need help. I'll shut down the city lights.
I will start kind of chatting with why we're here so early and what we're going to be doing. We have a decent amount of stuff to do. We are anticipating in about an hour that the bus will be here.
More if you need help, if you need help. Your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you. Maybe I'm not moving on.
South Africa has 9 states. The one we're currently in is called the Eastern Cape. So we're going to be driving all the way through the Eastern Cape and then into the Western Cape where Cape Town is.
And long after you're gone, gone, gone. When you fall like a statue, I'm going to be there to catch you, put you on your feet, you on your feet.
South Africa is a beautiful country. Town City Kama was just awesome. So all that stuff was great.
We've done bungee jumping, we've done zip lining, which has just been completely amazing.
We just bungee jumped off the one of the highest bungee jump places possible.
In the world, like in the world.
A trip I never thought I would have done it. And just the day when everyone went and people were saying, oh, do it, do it. And everyone kind of just went for it.
It was ridiculous. Life-changing experience, and I'll not regret that.
I don't see me not doing that ever again. That's got to happen again.
The worst part is when you initially get out there and you're waiting, and then the next part is when they have you go and put your toes over the line.
Yeah.
And you have to look down to make sure your toes are in the right spot, and that's kind of creepy, but I didn't look for long. You look up and then swan die.
I love you long after you're gone.
Personally, for me, in 2006, I will skip the bigger details on the whys and the hows for me, but I got very, very, very vested in getting involved with poverty. At that time, the focus was HIV/AIDS. We're getting ready for what we anticipate to be the breakout season for F&M soccer. Jumping into that in the preseason, we find out the word that Chris has passed away. The day before season starts. And Chris not only was, you know, everybody that knows soccer, the attacking midfielder is just like, there's a personality thing that unlocks things, and it just absolutely gutted the team.
We look at you guys the same way we look at Christopher. I mean, all it was potential. He was smart, he loved this game. He had lots of great things to offer, and, you know, the world really got cheated when he got taken from us. And when Chris passed away, they asked me, what do you want to do, like fly out? And I was like, no, just, you know, give the money to F&M for the trip. You know, that's what we wanted to do. You know, coach a few weeks later said, you know, money's kind of pouring in. What do you think about doing something a little more permanent? Let's do a turf field somewhere in New Khayelitsha. We, you know, all were quite frankly just sort of trying to do something, and now, like, you guys are the continuation of that. But that continuity and what goes on there, you know, it's all part of F&M soccer. It's part of what Christopher was. It's what you know, coach stands for. It's what this whole thing stands for. So, you know, you'll see it and you'll live it, and you know, it's gonna touch you in ways that I think you'll be surprised.
There's something about the field, I guess, that when you step on it, no matter what you're doing, you're there to just play around as a team, you're there to hang out with the kids, no matter what you're doing. It really feels like a special place.
The first thing you notice is that the gate opens and kids just start storming in, just want to play soccer, just want to hang out, want to talk to you.
It was so special just to be with the kids and to carry them like on our shoulders around the township with everyone from the township being there and seeing us and cheering for us and smiling, waving, and just the whole experience was amazing.
Just happy, happy, happy kids, even though they don't know that they don't realize they have much. I mean, there were kids running through the township with us without shoes on and all that, and it really puts things into perspective for what we have and appreciate what we have back in the States.
Kind of just connecting with the people at the field is awesome. Talking to the senior leaders, picking their brains, playing with the kids, you know, and just seeing how people in such abject poverty could still have such a sense of community.
But they have seen the beauty of enormous.
0 to 1, 1 is perfect inequality, 0 is perfect equality. 63 is really high inequality. So if you have an economic inequality of 63, that's actually one of the highest. You don't know what a township is, probably. You don't have a vision of what it is. You will see it. Black townships, colored townships, shacks, people's homes, made out of cardboard.
We all watched the program one, so we kind of got a sense that there are a lot of tribe and religions and some multilingual country and a lot of resources are divided.
We've visited Robben Island, which was where Nelson Mandela was imprisoned for a while.
Seeing Robben Island really just brought everything in full circle, made me realize the impact he actually had on this country.
Seeing the little cell he lived in for 18 years, I believe it was, and just amazing to see that, and the stories after reading his book, just the discussions we had every morning, just really shed some light on Mandela.
You make everything.
Pretty evident soccer can bring people together. Soccer is a worldwide language. Everybody speaks it, everybody wants to play.
The competition was very, very good down here. We played 4 games and we won 2 of them, tied 1, lost 1. I mean, each game was very competitive, each game was close. It was cool playing against these teams down here because it's a totally different style of play. Very individually talented, foot skills are awesome.
It was really interesting to kind of see the different style of play that's played down here. You know, it's a very different game than what we're used to.
And then compared with, you know, we're a very good team and we had a great season. So coming off of that and coming down playing a whole different style of soccer was cool to see, and it was cool to play against.
And it's not just about soccer. It's about building relationships with our teammates, establishing new ones with South Africans here, other people, other Americans that we've met, and really getting a chance to, you know, keep the team moving in a direction that we've established over the past couple of years.
This trip has most definitely brought the team closer, a lot closer.
Experiencing it with the team, with my band of brothers, has just been an extremely unique and just special experience.
All the bonding time we had as a group, you know, we'd spent 2 straight weeks with each other, bonding with the team, bonding with the parents. I think it's doing it in a different culture and an area where no one is really comfortable and no one has a comfort zone down here, I think that is only going to strengthen the bonds even more.
Khayelitsha is one of the most impoverished townships in South Africa, and we see that they can all smile and they can all be happy, and they are one giant big community and they're together. So, I mean, it begs the question that why can't we do that every day?
We're enjoying each other and you know, pulling pranks and whatever. Again, team bonding, team togetherness. Or whether, you know, we're standing out in the field, you know, losing 2-1, 2-0 to some great African side, and we have to look at each other and we have to say, you know, look at where we are, look at who we're with and how happy we are to be here. And this is something that we did together. You know, you didn't do alone. I know next year when we're playing against the Centennial Conference team and maybe we're struggling, we can say at the end of the day, hey, we look at each other and we say, yeah, but we won in Cape Town, so we can win here. You know, that was harder than this. We can do this.
Look at the team unity between the soccer team itself, and what they do. It's just unbelievable, the bonding experience these players have, you know, the competitive environment that they have had. But, you know, their involvement here as a team in South Africa and giving back is just going to reflect our communities when they get back home.
And it's family is what it boils down to. I know that's, you know, maybe a little cliche or a little bit whatever, but, and again, you know, you guys know it because you all picked this school. There's how many of you sitting in a room, you know, 7 years after these guys graduated, and it's like family.